All right, LSU baseball, Eastern Kentucky tonight. I wanted to ask you your opinion on LSU tinkering, because this is something we know. Paul, this is what Paul does. I mean, it's not like this is an uncommon thing. This is what he does every year. Comes in, sort of mixes and matches. But I guess the oddity is, it doesn't feel like it's just getting guys opportunities. It's like, do you know what I mean? It feels like you really just don't know. It's different if you got a young guy and you want to get him in, and you know, in the later innings, or give him a midweek start. It's almost like he doesn't know who his best shortstop is right now. He doesn't know who his best second baseman is. He doesn't know who his best option in center field is right now. I mean, and that feels different. To me, anyway.
Yeah, no, I agree with that wholeheartedly. So first off, you have an entire fall to figure that out. I mean, and now the rules, like, you can play games in the fall. I think they went down to Nichols
they
and
did.
Played a game.
They played Nichols. I think they played Tech, too. Didn't
played
they?
Tech.
Played Tech, yeah.
And so, and you have the inner squads, and you have the practices and the 401s and all that in the fall. It's a legit season, man. Like, you're at the field every day. And
or UNO. It was UNO, wasn't it? I'm sorry to interrupt. UNO. I'm sorry. Basketball played Tech in the relief game for the tournament. I'm sorry.
Yeah. And regardless, but you have that time to figure out who goes where, and you know, I would think that would be, you know, ample time to figure out the spots. But you know, sometimes it's different, man. And when the lights come on, and what kid shows up and what kid doesn't. So I can understand how it is difficult, you know, to really know what you have, and you can't make a lineup out based on the fall season, and that's the truth. But you should have a pretty good idea, which I think they do. But I'll tell you, from a player standpoint, man, it's really hard to show up at the field and not know what position you're playing. You know, it's like, and you and I talk at noon or 1 o'clock on most days, and you're getting ready for the show, and I can tell when you're prepared and when you're not. Or you'll even say it, man, I've done nothing for the show today. I've had to go here. Like today, you had five places you went to this morning, and so you're scrambling to get prepared. Well, what if you couldn't even scramble to get prepared? I mean, what if it was just show up, bam, do the show? You know, you get to the field and you've played third base for an entire fall, and then all of a sudden you've got 2 hours to play short. You got to figure out, now you're playing shortstop. Well, of course you're not going to cover a base, or you're going to miss the bag on a throwdown or whatever, because you just haven't been there. You know, not only physically you're not prepared, but mentally you're not prepared to play that position. It's very difficult from a player's standpoint to know to go into this thing and either, you know, I don't know if I'm going to be in the lineup or not. I don't know where I'm batting, and I don't know what position I'm playing. I don't think you're getting the best view of our defense because of that. Now, are they capable of playing the position? Sure, they're capable, but they're not prepared, man. And maybe you're just treating the front part of this season as that. You know, maybe it's kind of a throwaway, let's figure this thing out, and once we get in an SEC play, we'll have it locked and loaded. You know, and if that's the case, it is what it is. They're kind of learning on the fly. But I'll just say, from a player standpoint, man, it's tough, dude. It is. I was thrown into an outfield spot one time. We were in Cincinnati when I was with Chicago. And, you know, can you play outfield? Of course. Well, what am I going to say? No. You know, and I'm lost out there, like missing pop-ups. I've just never done it. You're just not prepared for that spot. So that's kind of what I see a little bit more than anything. You know, I've been asking former coaches all day today, you know, how much tinkering they did with the lineup and changes and stuff, because I personally don't remember. I know my freshman year I started at second base and stayed there pretty much the whole season. Maybe had a few games over at shortstop when Josh Dalton was needed a blow or was hurt, but you know, and stayed in the same spot in the lineup relatively consistently throughout that season. And then after that, it was, you're going to play shortstop, you're batting first. And that just, you know, kind of is what it is.
Yeah. How does I had a follow up, because you talked about how, you know, if you show up at the field and you don't know what you're going to play, how you might scramble a little bit. But, and I'm oversimplifying this, but as a kid, when you play ball, it's kind of what it is. You show up and the coach fills out the lineup and you go play. I mean, how does it, and I obviously never played college baseball, like, so how does it graduate at that level where, if you're an infielder, where your preparation in the time leading up to the game changes if you change positions?
So prior to a game, let's say I'm playing shortstop, I would, during batting practice, try to field every ground ball or fly ball that could possibly happen during that game. For instance, Ground ball hit right at me. Nobody on. I'd catch it, throw it to first. Ground ball hit right at me, man on first. Flip it to second. Ground ball hit right at me, man on first and second. Again, so I would mimic backhand in the hole, guy on second, tries to advance. I got to throw it to third. I would mimic every possible play, and it would take about 10 minutes. So it's not just ground ball, ground ball, ground ball, just wasted time. I was trying to mimic the play. That way, when it showed up during the game, I was prepared for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I mentally knew that I could make that play. Some days it would take longer than others. I mean, some days I would fly through it, and that would be a good defensive day. Other days I would suck, and so I'd have to be like, I got to work on this play or that play. So that being said, I mean, it's like studying for a test. I mean, you're going to go over the material that may be on that test that day, but if they don't know what's going to be on the test, then you know, it makes it hard.
Do you know?
And you mentioned the Little League stuff, dude. I try my best, and we try our best at traction. And this is with babies. I mean, this is with 12, 13, 14-year-olds. We try our best to let the kids know what position they're playing the day before that game. So we'll try. Doesn't always work out that way, but we'll try to give them an idea of where they're going to be, because we do move them around. But you want them to mentally prepare and know kind of where they're going to be. And it's just, it's a calming thing.
Yeah. Okay. So LSU is going to change it up. We're waiting for the lineup to be posted today. But we know that Malazzo is going to start two games at catcher this weekend. And we know that Hal Hughes is going to go back to shortstop. And they're still trying to figure out who's going to play center and who's going to, you know, where guys are going to fit in. My assumption is Mathis third, Doty at second. I mean, it seems to make the most sense there, that lineup that you started the season with. We'll see if any of that changes tonight or throughout the course of this weekend.